Welcome to another edition of Chaplain John with Chaplain John Sayers, featuring special reports and interviews with people doing kingdom ministry in Tulare County and beyond. And now, here's Chaplain John.
Hey, happy birthday. I guess I could call this a birthday party in 10 minutes or less, not counting the introduction, okay? Now, I'm going to cheat a little bit here on that timing because I'm still thinking what I'm doing right now, I'm still calling the introduction. And I'll let you know when the message begins, then you can time me, okay? 10 minutes or less, all right? But this is still the introduction. We have been on a journey, and it started actually Easter. And if you go back and look at my messages, 10 minutes, during the week, it's 5 minutes. I thought for 5 minutes, but this is where I get to preach, all right? But this is still the introduction. But the journey has been called the Great 50 Days. We've journeyed with Jesus during his resurrection. Great events in the life of Jesus, fantastic. Read about them in John 20 and 21, Luke 24, and we looked at these events. And then we actually traveled to, in the book of Acts, we were with Jesus when he ascended to the heavens. We did that. Now this is Acts chapter 2. This kind of wraps up this 50-day, because it's Pentecost. Now some of you, I hope, have already heard some good Pentecost messages on this day. I pray you have. If you haven't, or you would like to hear another one, I want to invite you to go to River Cross Church homepage. See the one that our Pastor Carl did from his own home. Great message. I could see Pastor Carl was getting so excited. I was going, my gosh, Pentecost brings out the Baptist in him. All right, tell a joke there. But this is our birthday, the birthday of the church. Now, we're going to begin, and now this is still the introduction, because it says this, and I want to focus in on this. I'll tell you when the message begins. All right. Okay. When the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all together in one accord, in one place. I want you to look at those two words. They were all together in one accord. That meant they all believed that Jesus was God. He was Lord and Savior. He had risen. They all had that, and that was the one accord. But they were also in one place. There's something about Jesus told them to wait in Jerusalem, wait in Jerusalem. And Jerusalem is not so much a place for me, but it's being with the presence of God. So when we come together, we can differ over a ton of things, but we do not differ over, is Jesus God? Yes. Did Jesus die on a cross for our sin? Yes. Did Jesus rise from the dead? Yes. That brings us together in one accord and one place. All right. And so when that happened, then now tying the sermon. All right. We'll call this the sermon right now. Okay. It said, then there appeared fires of tongues on them. There's disciples and women there, and they were given the power. They were given, let me just read this, I'm muddling it over. Then there appeared to them divided tongues as of fire, and one sat upon them, and they were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterances. Now, please, we're not talking about speaking in tongues. That's something else. This is giving them the language to speak in other languages. Why? Because in the streets that day, they were gathered, they were there for another festival called the Feast of Harvest, and talk about that more. But the people are there, and they're hearing these Jewish people speaking in their own language. Now, these were Jews that came from all around, and they may have spoken different languages, and they're hearing them speak in their language, and they're amazed. I think this is the reverse of the Tower of Babel. Read about that in Genesis 10, I believe, where they didn't have one spirit. They didn't have one accord. They were trying to be like God and build this tower. Well, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and it confused their language. And then one went this way, one. That's how we got different languages today. You know, we're all one race, but we got different languages. This is the reverse. Now they're one spirit, one accord, and they're given the gift to speak. Now they're talking in their different languages. And some of the Jewish people there that lived in Jerusalem said, what's going on? They're all amazed. What's happening? They're going, my gosh, I'll tell you what's happening. They're drunk, they said. This is really interesting. You got to read on this. They're they're snuckered. And Peter gets up. Peter gets up in front of a crowd. Peter is still going to make some goofs even after Pentecost, bless his heart. But he is never going to deny Jesus again. He gets up in the crowd and says, people, this is what the prophet Joel had been prophesying. Joel was a prophet some 500 years before this. I don't check the dates on that. And he had a prophecy. And I think there's two parts to his prophecy. But here, Peter quotes and says, in the prophecy, he says, here's what Joel prophesied. And you've heard this many a times going to the synagogue. He said this, and it shall come to pass in the last day, says the Lord, that I'll pour my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. That prophecy, Joel was saying, isn't happening, but Peter's saying it's happening right now. Prophecy means proclaiming the word of God, sharing the word of God. And it's happening. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will see dreams. That's happening right now. Never put down a young guy. Never put down an old guy, because we're having visions and dreams today. On my men servants and my maid servants, I will pour my spirit on these days, and they shall prophesy. This is, I don't care what level of life you're in, rich, poor, middle class, whatever, homeless, home, the Holy Spirit's going to fall on all of us. That's exciting. Now, that was going on. Right now, Peter says it's happening now, the next part of his prophecy. I don't think it's happening yet. Maybe soon. He says, I'll show wonders in the heaven, signs in the earth, blood and fire and vapors of smoke. The sun will be turned into darkness and the moon into blood. Hey, have you ever seen the sun turn to darkness? Sometimes we call it what? An eclipse? Ever seen a blood moon? Well, maybe we're closer than we think. Before the coming awesome day of the Lord, and it shall come to pass that whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Oh my gosh. And the people are hearing, and they may be hearing this message from the others in different languages. And there are some 3,000 people in the street that day. And they cry out, what must we do to be saved? What must we do? It wasn't Peter's great sermon or their prophecy. The Spirit was moving amongst them that day. And that's what made them cry out, what shall we be saved? And Peter and the others said, be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. And, you know, basically repent and be baptized. And that day, you know, that day, Peter says, repent and let every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sin. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, the promises to you and to your children and all who are far off in many lands, the Lord God will call. That day, 3,000 people, wow, came into the church. That is the birthday of the church. And the world has never been same before. That's Pentecost. Happy birthday, body of Christ. That's Pentecost. Amen. Oh, my gosh. And I did all of that in 10 minutes or less. Well, even counting the introduction. Happy birthday, church.